Everyone, please turn on camera. So in polynomial chapter, this chapter is small, but still consists of near about 90 questions. Okay, so this is polynomials. Mostly we are learning, this chapter is divided into three parts. First one is the properties of quadratic polynomial. First part is the graphs of understanding the graphs of quadratic polynomial, different types of polynomials, linear, quadratic, and cubic polynomial. Second part, the relation between the zeros of the polynomial and coefficients of quadratic polynomial. Third part, the same relation for cubic polynomials. And the fourth part is division algorithm. So this chapter is divided into four parts. All small parts are there. So starting with the first part, what do you mean by polynomial? Algebraic expression that you know. What do you mean by algebraic expressions?
Mom, an expression which consists of constant variables and
constant variables, arithmetic operations.
Yes, ma'am.
So the expressions which consists of the numerals, which is the constant numbers, variables, A to Z, any of the alphabet we use it, and along with that, the arithmetic operation, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, right? So such all expressions we call as algebraic expressions, the combination of arithmetic operation, numbers, constant numbers, and variables that we call as algebraic expressions. All the now polynomials, all the algebraic expressions, polynomials are algebraic expressions. But all algebraic expressions cannot be considered as polynomials. There is some criteria that algebraic expression has to fulfill to say that expression as a polynomial. So condition necessary to say any algebraic expression as polynomial is, what's the condition? Which algebraic expressions we can consider as polynomial?
And whose degree is a whole number?
The negative power.
Yes, Vaibhavi? Degrees, yes, Soma is right.
Do not have any negative or rational number power.
Yes, right. It should be a whole number we can consider. And not only degree, any of the variable. We are not only concerning with degree here. The power of every variable in that algebraic expression should be a whole number. Power or exponent of variable, only variable is whole number. That means it could be a numbers from 0 to infinity. So that means there should not be no negative numbers. And no fractions, exponents, powers. Power should not be negative numbers or power should not be fractions. Then such algebraic expressions, we call them as polynomials. For example, x square plus 5 is a polynomial or not?
It is, mom.
It is a polynomial because variable is x, x's power is plus 2. So it is a polynomial. Yes, it is a polynomial. Root 5x plus x square plus 7 by 2x cube.
It is a polynomial.
It is a polynomial.
So here x's power is 1. Here x's power is 2. here x is power is 3. So all these are whole numbers. So therefore, yes, it is a polynomial.
Mom, should we write along?
Yeah. So first write down this. I will take some examples and then you will write. X plus 1 by x is?
Not a polynomial.
Not a polynomial.
Why?
Mom, because 1 by x can be written as x to the power minus 1. And
yes, right.
It cannot
1
have
by x, power. We can write as x to the power minus 1. So here it is negative power. So it is not a polynomial.
Not a polynomial.
Why it is not a polynomial?
Mom, x can be
written
as
1 by 2. So here you can see root 3x. X is inside the square root. So it can be written as 5x square plus root 3x to the power 1 by 2 plus 1. So x is power 1 by 2. So here fraction, not possible. So it is not a polynomial. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so write down this and then I will give you one more question based on this.
Ma'am, one thing I wanted to inform that my mother had come. But that time, I think the institution was not open.
What time it was? After 4, it will be open.
11 o'clock she came, ma'am.
No, it's not afternoon. It is only in the evening. 5 to 9. Okay. So 4 to 8:30, go and collect it.
Okay. So tomorrow, I think my mother will come.
Yeah, fine. Tomorrow, 5 o'clock onwards. First off, classes are not there. So right now it is not going on. So sitting also is problematic. Sir, generally he used to there in the morning, but now he's not.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, in the fourth example, 3x, the whole should be as 1 by 2, right?
Yeah, so I have written root 3 and x to the power 1 by 2. I've separated.
Ma'am, shouldn't it be 3x to the power 1 by 2?
3 into x. So you can exponent, you can separate them also. Okay. Whatever you are telling, that is also right.
Can, ma'am.
Ma'am, do we write the examples now?
Yes, we'll write down those.
then you can solve this question. Which of the following are not polynomials?
Mom, do we write all the polynomials given?
Yes, all the polynomials given. Out of that, which one is polynomial and which one is not polynomial?
Okay, Mom.
Vijay, can you tell which of them are polynomial? Vijay, are you there?
Yes, Mom.
Yeah, first one is polynomial or not?
Yes, ma'am, polynomial.
It is polynomial. Second one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Third one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Fourth one?
No, ma'am.
No. Fifth one?
No, ma'am.
Why?
Ma'am.
Why it is not?
Oh.
We are only concerned with variable.
Oh, okay. Ma'am, yes, ma'am. Fine. Yeah. Sorry, ma'am. The yes, ma'am. It's a polynomial.
This one?
Yes, ma'am, polynomial.
Just see properly. Two x square plus 3 minus 5 by x.
Oh, ma'am, it's minus. Okay, fine. I just saw 2 x square plus 3.
Minus 5 by x. X is in the denominator.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. I just saw 2 x square plus 3. Yes.
The next one? 5 x minus 1 by 2?
Yes, ma'am, it's a polynomial.
The next?
Polynomial.
Next?
No.
Completed. And which one of these is a quadratic polynomial? Which one of these is
3x squared plus 7x plus
2? 3x squared plus 7x plus 2. Okay. Any other?
No, ma'am.
No, only one quadratic polynomial. Now, completed everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Lochan, Lakshya, have you finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ambika?
Yes, Aristan, ma'am.
Ayush, Siddha, Deepika.
Yes, ma'am.
Navika. Yes, ma'am.
Mohit, Navika.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, next part is the types of polynomials according to their degree. What is degree means?
Highest
from the highest power.
exponential value.
Highest exponential value, highest power of variable. So, for example, if you write 2x plus x cube plus x to the power 4 minus 7 x square. In this case, what is degree?
4.
4.
Degree is 4. Because maximum, this is 1. Nothing is there. By default, it is 1, 3, 4, and 2. The highest value is 4. So, therefore, degree 4. Now, according to degree, one by one, we have given them special names. So, for first one is called as linear polynomial. So, linear polynomial, degree 1. Degree is 1, then it is called as linear polynomial. Don't write first lesson. So, linear polynomial where degree 1. So, its general formula is, generally how we can write that, ax plus b. We write the linear polynomial in this form, ax plus b, where a and b belongs to any real numbers. A and b are the real numbers. X is only the variable. Okay, these are real numbers. So for example, 2x plus 3, 7 by 5 y, 2y minus 7 by 2. These are all, here variable is x, power is 1. Power is 1. Power is 1. Then all these are called as linear polynomial. Now the number of zeros. What do you mean by zero of a polynomial? What is mean by zero of the polynomial?
The value. If we substitute it, then the final value equals 0.
It will be 0, right? Once, just give. So, zero of the polynomial means the value of x. A value of x is a. It's substituted in the polynomial px. If you got the value of that px as whatever it is, then p of a becomes zero. That means a polynomial is given. In that, some value of x, when you substitute in that polynomial, if the value of the polynomial becomes zero, then x is equal to a is called zero of the polynomial. For example, take an example of 2x minus 4 is equal, it is a polynomial, right? Now, which value of x you have to substitute to get the answer zero?
2.
If we substitute x is equal to 2 in this polynomial, what we will get? 2 into 2 minus 4, 4 minus 4, answer is zero. So after substituting x value as 2, if we get the value of the polynomial 0, then this value is called 0 of the polynomial. Able to understand?
Yes, ma'am.
So now how many zeros a linear polynomial has?
One.
It has at most one. Not only one. At most one. That means it can be zero or one zeros. Number of zeros will be zero. That means no zero. Or it has one zeros. Okay. Always remember, if a polynomial with degree n, then it will have number of zeros at most n. So mostly n. That is one here. Now the graph of linear polynomial. No need, you are not supposed to draw. You have already drawn last year. So whenever linear polynomial graph you draw, you will get a straight line. So the straight line like this, you will get it. Or you will get like this. Or possibility like this. Anything possible. I will draw all three different cases. So this is first possibility, right? Either this, or you will get like, it is curved like this way. This is x-axis, this is y-axis. Like this way you will get it, or you will get the structure like this. This is x and y-axis, then you will get the graph like this. So it should be always a straight line. Graph of linear polynomial has always straight line graph. Straight line graph. Now finding, we, from the graph we can find the number of zero. That is, we have to find the point of intersection. So in how many points the graph intersect x-axis, that many number of zeros the polynomial will have. The number of zeros we can find out by counting number of intersection points, intersecting points between graph and x-axis. So here, this is a graph, is a line, is a graph that intersect x-axis at how many points?
One
point. So it has 1, 0. So it is intersecting at this point. So this is x1, it has only 1, 0. Now this line intersect at
one
point. This is x1, so it has 1, 0. And now here in this case,
zero.
So here it is not intersecting x-axis, it is a line parallel to x-axis. So no intersection, so no zeros. No zero, that means zero zeros. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So when it is 1, 0 and when it is 0, 0, is that clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. You have to find the graph. Graph will be given. Find the point of intersection with x-axis. And how many points the graph intersect x-axis, that is the number of zeros. And the value of that x-axis, that point of coordinate, is the zero of the that polynomial. Clear? Able to understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, now write down for the linear polynomial. Till which part you have written? This question you have written now from this. Start writing. Now we have to see quadratic and cubic. Understanding this graph is important because you have a case study question based on these graphs. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, do we write the zero of the polynomial as well?
So you have to draw all the graphs and write the number of zeros.
Ma'am, can you scroll a bit down?
Ma'am, now can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay.
You have shut down and started.
Yes, ma'am. I did a manually start.
Done, ma'am.
Everyone completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Next is quadratic polynomial. This is the type of polynomial in which degree is 2. Then those all polynomials we call as quadratic polynomials. General form is ax square plus bx plus c, where a, b, c are real numbers. ABC are called real numbers. Okay. So this is a general form. Here the degree is 2. Maximum power of any variable is 2. So therefore it is quadratic polynomial. Now number of zeros. It has at most 2. That means either 0 or 1 or 2 it has. The graphs of this polynomial, if we draw, then we will get the U-shaped graphs. The graphs like U-shaped structure. So this U-shape is called as parabola. The name of this shaped graphs are called parabola. Okay. Now there are different types of graphs are there for quadratic. One is first type is? Like this. Second type is this. Third type, don't draw anything right now.
Ma'am, in this we should draw the graph, or it's the graph will be given?
Graph will be given. You are not supposed to draw any graph. Okay. This is one kind of the graph of quadratic polynomial. Here, this is x-axis. The graph touches x-axis at two different points. So these two points of intersection with x-axis are the number of zeros. So this is x1 and this is x2. So two values of x which makes the polynomial zero. So therefore there are two zeros. Here also the graph intersects two points, x-axis at two points. So therefore number of zeros will be two zeros here also. And two zeros are unequal zeros. Both of them are not equal zeros, unequal zeros. That is also we call as distinct zeros. In this case, the graph has only one. It is intersecting at only one point. So actually it has two zeros, but both of them are equal. So value of x which satisfied that equation is only one. So therefore we can write as it has one zero. Able to understand, every quadratic equation have two zeros always, or no zero. When two zeros are again possibility that two zeros are different zeros and two zeros are same zeros. That means same value of x only is satisfying the equation. So in this case, if the graph is only touching at one point of x-axis, then it will have two equal zeros. Two zeros, but value of x is same, equal zeros. Then in that case, we are considering as it has only one zero. It's clear? For example, x square minus 4x plus 4. In this case, what are the factors?
Ma'am, in this case, it is x minus 2 the whole square. So,
x minus x 2 is whole equal to square. 2. So x minus 2 into x minus 2. To find zeros, we have to equate this to 0. And each fact brackets equate it to 0 and find the value of x like this. X minus 2 is equal to 0. Value of x is 2. So you got two equal zeros. Last year till this part you have done. Finding factors. Now finding 0, equate those two factors separately to zero and solve simple equation to find the value of x. This is the way to find zeros. Now in such case we got two zeros, but both of them are equal, so we'll consider it as a one zero only. So it has one zero. In this case it is also touching at one position, so how many zeros it has?
One.
It has one zero. And in this case?
Zero.
Zero, zero. Zero,
zero. Zero, zeros. So no zeros actually. And now what is a example of this kind for where no zeros are possible? X square plus one. In this case, what is the possible values of x square?
Ma'am, possible value is... No, there's no possible value, ma'am.
No value of x can satisfy this equation, because we need here to make this equation zero, we have to equate it to zero. We will get x square is equal to minus one. That means x is equal to square root of minus one. Is it possible to find the value of x? Not possible. So no value of x can satisfy this equation. Therefore, it has no zero. If we try to draw the graph, we will get this kind of a graph, which won't touch x-axis. It's clear, different types of quadratic polynomials?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
And now one thing, when it is upward parabola, and this is downward parabola, when you will get this? When the coefficient of x square, that is value of a, x square's coefficient is a is positive, then you will get upward parabola. That means it will open at top. And we open, the parabola opens downwards. In that case, value of a will be negative. When the value of a is negative, then you will get the downward parabola. A is negative. And in this case, a is positive. Able to understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Upward parabola, when the variable a is positive, and downward parabola means a is negative. Okay. So right
ma'am, now, I have a doubt.
Yes.
Ma'am, could you please scroll down? Yes, ma'am. On the left side, only the parabola is touching the x-axis only at one point. So, ma'am, how does it have two equal zeros?
It is touching one point. We know that a quadratic polynomial always have two zeros.
Yes, ma'am.
But those two zeros can be same or not same. If they are not same, we will get the graph like this. It is touching, intersecting x-axis at two points. But if it has x value, same value of x is no. Zero is the same value of x.
Okay, ma'am. So we give equation like this, x square minus 4x.
No. This is as an example I told you.
Okay, ma'am. So is it necessary that always we factorize and then find the zero of?
Yes. Yeah. Finding zero is that is always by factorization.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, do we write it down?
Yes, write down. Ma'am,
ma'am, if there are suppose both upward and downward parabola,
then it, one parabola for one equation, two parabola means two equations. Jai, your camera is not on. Sunanda again absent yesterday.
Yes, ma'am.
Tanisha absent today.
Ma'am, can you scroll it? Done, ma'am.
Joseph, are you there?
Ma'am, can you scroll a bit down the example?
Mom, just a second.
Next one is cubic polynomial where degree is 3.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Can you scroll a bit up? Yes, ma'am, done.
So cubic polynomial has a degree 3. General form is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus t, where a, b, c, d are real numbers, any real number. So it can be rational or irrational. Okay. Now number of zeros. How many number of zeros it will have?
At most three.
That is either 1, 0, 1, 2, or 3. Graphs are S or Z shaped structure. Graph is like this. These are the possible graphs. In this case, it is intersecting 3 points. So therefore, it has 3 zeros. It is now intersecting how many points?
2
points. So therefore, it has 2 zeros. In this case?
1
zero. It won't intersect also. No? So in this case, if it is like this, then in this case, it is not intersecting x-axis. So zero zeros. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now from this, what you have learned, one statement that you have to learn from this part is, if a polynomial, for a polynomial with degree n has at most n zeros, polynomial with degree n has at most n zeros. Now here the question based on this is, graph will be given. You have to find the number of zeros from the graph. Okay. So graph will be given. So you have to find out the number of zeros from that. But there you have to take care of one thing. It will be given, find the number of zero for the given graph where x is equal to f of x, or another equation, x is equal to f of y. This means here in this case, the polynomial in variable x and this is polynomial or a function in variable y. Here, this means in this case, finding number of zeros is done with finding intersection of graph with x-axis. Finding points of intersection of graph and x-axis. And in this case is with y-axis, point of intersection with y-axis. Finding points of intersection of graph and y-axis. Able to understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So at the end of this page, graph exercise, the book I have given you, in that at the end, these questions are there. The last question.
Mom, I got disconnected for a while. Could you please scroll up? Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah, tell me the number of zeros from every graph. Aristan, first one, how many zeros it has?
Ma'am, it has one.
It has one zero. Okay. Aishwarya? Wait. One by one. Aishwarya?
Yes, ma'am.
This one has?
Two.
Two zeros. Deepika, third one has?
It has two. Three.
Three zeros. Vaibhavi, fourth one?
One zero.
One zero. Siddharth?
Yes, ma'am. Hello?
How many zeros?
Ma'am, one.
One zero. Ambika?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, sixth one has four zeros.
Four zeros. Soumya?
Yes, ma'am. No zeros.
No zeros. Prithvi?
One zero.
One zero. Parush?
and three zeros.
Three zeros. Atish?
Two zeros.
Two zeros. Lochan?
Four zeros.
Four zeros. Lakshya?
Three zeros.
Three zeros. Now everyone clear? This kind of a question is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now the last question. This question, consider this as x only, horizontal as x. And this is y axis. Now, and they have given for following graph, x is equal to f of y. So Vijay, can you tell me the answer? How many zeros it has?
Ma'am, two.
How two? Are you able to see the graph? Mohit, how many zeros it has? Vijay told two, right? Mohit, are you there?
Mom, can I?
Mohit, are you there?
Mom, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Ma'am, my microphone couldn't connect. Ma'am, three.
Where exactly? Three? What are the values?
Ma'am, there are two. Yeah, there's one up there and two here.
Vijay, clear?
Ma'am, no, yes, ma'am. There's only 1 0.
Mommy, you told we should use the vertical one.
It's so only 1 0. Look at the x and y.
This is, I'm telling you, this is x and this is y. Consider it.
Then okay.
I told this. Actually, I could not get the graph for that. So therefore, I have taken the same graph and tilted it.
Ma'am, so answer is 3.
3 zeros.
Ma'am, one is on minus 5, one is on 2 and 3, right?
Yeah, right.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood? School, this part of x is equal to fy, the board won't ask. School asks. So in school, very careful with these questions. Most of the time, they will give you x is equal to fy. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood this part?
Yes, ma'am.
Finding graphs, from the graphs, finding zeros.
Yes, ma'am.
And the point of intersection are the values of x. So here the point of intersection, if you consider the straight y, it is minus 5, 2 and 3. So these are the values of x or zeros of that polynomial. Okay. Now next part of the chapter is quadratic polynomial in detail. In this case, we have to learn the relation between zeros of the polynomial and coefficients of variables. Quadratic polynomial general form is written as ax squared plus bx plus c. Now, every quadratic polynomial has at most two zeros. So we are considering it is as a two zeros. They might be equal, they might not be equal, doesn't matter. It has two zeros. That means the value of x, substituting in this equation, the equation value should become, polynomial value should become zero. Those are two zeros. We consider those two values of x are considered as one as alpha and second one as beta. Able to understand what is alpha and beta means?
Ma'am, could you repeat quadratic polynomial again?
Two zeros of the polynomial, that means two values of x will satisfy this polynomial. The finding value of this polynomial will become zero. So those two values of x we consider as alpha and beta.
Okay, ma'am.
For example, see here, x square minus 5x plus 6. This is a polynomial. What are the factors of this? X square minus 3x, middle term splitting. So it will be x minus 3 minus 2 into x minus 3, x minus 3 into x minus 2. So these are the two factors. Now from this, when we want to find out zero, we have to equate each of them separately to zero and find the value of x. So here value of x is 3, value of x is 2. So these are the two zeros of the polynomial. You can check, substitute x in 3 in this equation, you will get the answer 0. 3 square, 9 minus 5 into 3, 15 plus 6. Check. 9 minus 15 is minus 6 plus 6, answer is 0. And try substituting x is equal to 2 also. 2 square is 4 minus 5 into 2, 10 plus 6. 4 minus 10 is minus 6 plus 6, answer is 0. So for these two values of x, the value of the polynomial becomes 0. So therefore, these two are called zeros of the polynomial. And for these values, we have considered as variable alpha and beta. Able to understand now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, these alpha and beta and this A, which is a coefficient of x square, B, which is a coefficient of x, and C is a constant term. There is a relation between these five. So that relation we have to learn. So what is that relation? Is the sum of these zeros. Sum of zeros, that is alpha plus beta. It is always equal to minus of B by A. B is coefficient, minus of coefficient of X. And A is coefficient of X square. Able to understand?
Ma'am, the minus is only for B?
Yeah, only for B.
Okay.
So you can see here, 3 and 2 are the zeros, this side, right hand side. 3 plus 2 is what? Alpha is 3 here and beta is 2. So what is 3 plus 2?
5.
And check, find the value of minus B by A from this. This is the equation. So from that, find the value of minus B by A. What's the answer?
Minus 5.
Minus of B by A.
5.
Minus of minus 5 by 1, which is plus 5 by 1, which is 5, right? So both the answers are same?
Yes, ma'am.
And it will happen for all the polynomials. So for all quadratic polynomials, sum of the zeros is always equal to negative of middle term, that is coefficient of x, by coefficient of x square. And second relation is product of zeros is equal to alpha into beta, that is always equal to C by A. So what is C? C is the constant term by coefficient of X square. It's clear?
Yes,
check. Here also in this equation, alpha is 3, beta is 2. So product is 3 into 2, 6. And here C by A is, C is 6 by A is 1. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
Ma'am, the product of zeros will be, ma'am, C by A. That is 6. By
1.
1, right?
Yeah. So 6 by 1 is 6.
So the product of
3 into 2 is
6.
6. So both are equal.
Okay, ma'am. Got it.
I have a question.
Yes.
Ma'am, what's the actual use of pantheon
meter? Not getting your voice clearly.
Ma'am, what's the actual use of pantheon meter?
Actually, you know, we have taken any variable, just like we are using A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z, like that, alpha and beta are the two variables.
So it's just a replacement for X and Y.
Yeah. Any two alphabets, instead of alphabets, they have used these word, these symbols.
Why, ma'am? They could just keep alphabets, right?
They have used, we have to use.
Ma'am, can we write?
Yes, you're writing down. I'm waiting for that only.
Mom, could you scroll?
Nothing is there upside. Those are the questions which we have solved. We have started from this only. Computer?
Ma'am, just a minute.
Yes, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Okay. Other students completed? Now, how we got these relations? That is also interesting from where we are only learning. How we got these relations? Now, see, you have given the equation as ax square plus bx plus c. The zeros of this are alpha and beta, right? Now, by knowing alpha and beta, we will try to form the polynomial. Now, from backwards, we have to go. For the c, if 3 and 2 are the zeros, now can we form the polynomial? For that, we have to go backwards. So x is equal to 3 and x is equal to y 2 are the zeros. Then what are the factors? Zeros are x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 2. So what are the factors of the polynomial?
1, 2 and 3.
Zeros are 2 and 3. Factors will be?
x minus 3 and x minus 2.
So if these two are factors of the polynomial, then what will be the polynomial? If 3 and 5 are the factors.
Of both the factors.
Yes. If 3 and 5 both are the factors of given given number. So how to find out the number?
3 into 5
you have done. Similarly, if these two are factors, then forming polynomial is product of these two. X minus 3 into x minus 2. So what is the product? X square minus 3x minus 2x plus 6, which is equal to
-5
x square minus 5x plus 6. We got the same equation. We got the same equation, x square minus 5x plus 6.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. the same method we have to apply for alpha and beta. Now equation is this. This is our original equation. Now if alpha and beta are zeros, so zeros are alpha and beta. So that means x is equal to alpha and x is equal to beta. So what are the factors?
X minus alpha and x minus beta.
X minus beta. Now how to form the polynomial?
Product.
Product
is equal to x minus alpha into x minus beta. So try to form the polynomial x square minus alpha x minus beta x plus alpha beta. So this is equal to x square minus of, we have taken common, minus negative value we have taken common from this two, alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Now this polynomial and this polynomial, both are same polynomials? Both of them are same?
Yes,
just like here, this we got an earlier value we got. They both of them are same. So we try to equate them. So this is also equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Both of them are same, but here it is in the terms of coefficients a, b, c. And here the polynomial is in the form of zeros. Okay. Now we have to check out what is the x square coefficient. Now here is a, but x square coefficient here is 1. So can we try to convert this in the coefficient as 1 only? This polynomial we have to convert in such a form that we will get the coefficient of x square as 1.
Divided by a.
Dividing with a. So we will have this as x square plus b by a into x plus c by a. This polynomial and this polynomial both are same. Now compare them. So what is the coefficient of x square is 1, 1. So what is the coefficient of x in both the places? Both are same. So they should be equal. The coefficient should be equal. So what is the coefficient of x here?
Minus of alpha plus beta.
Minus of alpha plus beta. And this side it is?
B by a.
B by a. So what is the value of alpha plus beta is equal to?
Minus b by a.
B by a.
This is minus b by a. This is our one relation, first relation. And see the product, constant term, alpha, beta. And here constant term is c by a.
B by a.
So alpha, beta is equal to c by a is second relation. Clear?
Ma'am, is this derivation important?
No. I told you because most of the students are curious from where this relation came. For your curiosity, I explained. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Because I won't leave anything. Like directly, I won't give formula and told you to mug up. I can't tell you that. We need to tell you from where that for relation came. Okay? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So write it down.
Ma'am, for this, what is the heading?
verification relation between coefficients and zeros of the polynomial.
Okay, ma'am. Mom, can you scroll it up?
Done, ma'am.
Now the question based on this is verify the relation between the coefficients and the zeros of the polynomial.
Ma'am, can you wait for 2 minutes?
Ma'am, the type 1 questions in the textbook,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, type questions.
Ma'am, this one we should write only the x square minus in bracket alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta, right?
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
Done, ma'am.
So type 1 question. Find the zeros of each of the following quadratic polynomial and verify the relation between the zeros and their coefficients. So for this, you have to do, first you have to factorize. Factorization done by middle term splitting. Hope everyone remember middle term splitting. Now here, product has minus 8, so difference should be minus 2. What are the middle terms?
Minus 4 and 2.
Minus 4.
Minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. Factorize x into bracket x minus 4 plus 2 into bracket x minus 4. So x minus 4 into x plus 2. Equate it to 0. X minus 4 is equal to 0. So value of x is 4. X plus 2 is equal to 0. So x value will be?
Minus 2.
Minus 2. So 4 and minus 2 are the two zeros. So that means one value is alpha, second value is beta. Now from the equation, what is the value of A?
1.
It's 1. B is coefficient of x. It is?
Minus 2.
Minus 2. And C will be?
Minus 8.
Minus 8. Now first relation, sum of zeros. That is alpha plus beta is equal to 4 plus minus 2. That is equal to 4 minus 2. Answer is 2. Now minus B by A. What is minus of minus 2 by A is 1. Minus of minus means plus 2. So both are same. So therefore alpha plus beta is equal to minus B by A verified. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
And the second relation is product. Product of zeros. That is alpha into beta equal to 4 into minus 2. That is minus 8. And alpha beta, we have to show it is equal to C by A. So what is the value of C?
Minus 8.
minus 8.
Minus 8 by 1.
Minus 8 by 1, which is minus 8. So both of them are equal. So therefore, alpha beta is equal to C by A. That is also verified. Clear? How to show?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Solve. The book given from that first type, first question. I have solved.
For the second one, first answer is 1, alpha plus beta, and alpha into beta is 1 by 3.
You're right.
Ma'am, till where are we supposed to solve the question?
Continue solving.
Okay.
I need to ask some questions so that you can solve. Third one solve. Third and fourth both solve.
Okay.
Solve the third one also, fourth one also.
Ma'am, for the second one, the first one is 1 and the second one is 1 by 4, right?
Yes, right. third one, what are the zeros?
Ma'am, the zeros are 2x minus 3 and 3x plus
those 1. Those are factors.
Oh, so sorry, ma'am. Alpha is equal to 3 by 2 and beta is equal to minus 1 by 3.
Right.
And what are the zeros for the second one?
Second one are x minus 2, I think so. Zeros are 2 and 2. Both are 2, 2.
Yes, ma'am.
No, 1 by 2, 1 by 2. Sorry. S minus 1 whole square, so S is 1 by 2.
Mom?
Yes?
How do we do the fourth one?
Fourth one. Hmm. It is in the form of t square is equal to t square minus 15 equated to 0. So what is the value of t square? T square minus 15 is equal to 0. So what
is root 15? Root 15.
No, it is t square is equal to 15. So value of t will be
root 15.
Square root of 15, but it is both positive and negative. Square root of any number will be either positive or negative, both. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So alpha value is plus root 15 and beta value will be minus root 15. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
All four completed. Now one question I will solve and after that you can leave because then only I can give you homework. In this question, there is a square root numbers. So how to factorize this? X square plus 2 root 2x minus 6. Now for this case, you need, what is the needed product of two terms should be? Minus 6. So minus 6, so difference of two terms is equal to 2 root 2 is needed. So we're finding this, we need root 2 in this. So 6 is factorized as?
2 into 3.
3 into 2. And we need root 2. So can we further divide 2 into root 2, root 2?
Root 2 into root 2.
And 3 will remain same. So now, what are the two terms we can take? We need root 2 will go with one term. 1 root 2 will go with one term. And 6 root 2 will go with second term. So it will become 3 root 2 and root 2. Right? So this is one of the term is 3 root 2 and the second term will be 2 root 2. So largest term should have the middle number sign. So middle number is positive. So larger number should have the plus sign. So this is plus and this is negative. Understood?
Yes.
Ma'am, I didn't understand.
You have to factorize the middle numbers. You need two middle terms, you have to split. But it is the product of two terms should be 6. So divide 6 in such a way that you should get root 2 in that. Root 2 we need. So 3 and 2 are the first factors. 2 can be written as root 2 into root 2. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
So now check the combinations. 1 root 2 should go with someone. And root 2, second root 2 should go with the another term. But 3 further we can't factorize. So along this root 2 will stick with this 3 and root 2 will go alone.
Yes, ma'am.
Then only if root 2 are present in both the terms, then only we can add or subtract. We need to make them like terms. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now this factorize separately. This is x in bracket. X plus 3 root 2. And here minus 6 is only written as this much. 3 into root 2 into root 2. So root 2 can we take common? So root 2 in bracket, it is plus out of this. This is the product is 6. So out of that root 2 we have taken common. So what is left out?
3 root 2.
3 root 2. 3 root 2.
So it will be, now you will get the factors as x plus 3 root 2 and x minus root 2. So these are the two factors. So zeros will be x minus 3 root 2, x is equal to root 2. Clear? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So write down and then you can leave. And you have to finish that first main.
Mom, till where are we supposed to finish?
First main you have to finish till Monday.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, one more thing. Ma'am, could you make new folders in Google Form to upload?
Yeah, for polynomials, I will make the second one.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.